वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम सूर्य प्रकाश ठाकर, एमसी डिपार्टमेंट, इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज बीकानेर। इन द प्रीवियस सेक्शन आई सेंट वन वीडियो लेक्चर स्टेटिंग वेरियस क्लस्टरिंग टेक्नोलॉजी एंड इट्स इंट्रोडक्शन, इन विच वी थ्योरेटिकली डिस्कस्ड के मीन्स एल्गोरिथम। हियर वी विल डिस्कस के मीन्स एल्गोरिथम इन डिटेल अलॉन्ग विद वन एग्जाम्पल। As see, first it selects k number of objects at random from the set of n objects. These k objects are treated as centroids or center of gravity of k clusters. For each of the remaining objects, it is assigned to one of the closest centroid. Thus, it forms a collection of objects assigned to each centroid and is called a cluster. Next, the centroid of each cluster is then updated by calculating the mean and repetitively. The assignment and update procedure is until it reaches some stopping criteria, such as number of iterations centroids remain unchanged or no assignment. Now the algorithm takes input D as a data set containing n objects and k is the number of clusters. The output would be a cluster of k, a set of cluster k clusters. The first step states that randomly choose k objects from D as the initial cluster center. No. Second steps take a loop which have two tasks to perform. First is compute distance between the current object and the k cluster center. Assign the current object to that cluster to which it is closest. Now third step says that compute the cluster centroids of each cluster. These become the new cluster centroids. Then fourth step says that this second and third step keep on repeating until convergence criteria is satisfied. Fifth is stop. Now k-means algorithm takes attribute set A which contains elements from A1 to AM where each AI is continuous data type. Distance computation is any distance such as L1, L2, L3 or cosine similarity. Minimum distance is the measure of closeness between an object and the centroid. Mean calculation is made using the mean value of each attribute value of all objects. Convergence criteria says that following are the termination conditions of the algorithm. First is number of maximum iteration possible, no change of centroid value. Third is zero or no significant movement of object from one cluster to another. Cluster quality reaches to a certain level of acceptance. Now in this example, attribute value have been given A1 as A2 for the 16 different data items in set A. Now they have been plotted in figure 16.1. A1 has been plotted upon x-axis and A2 contain y-axis. And through that, those distances will be measured, that we will see in the next slide. Suppose k is equal to 3, that is we have to partition it into 3 clusters. 3 objects are chosen at random, as it was shown in the previous slide. These 3 centroids are shown below in a table C1, C2, C3 for which values have been given for attributes A1, A2. Let us consider the Euclidean distance for that is L2 norm as a distance measurement in our illustration. Let D1, D2, D3 denotes the distance from one object to C1, C2 and C3 respectively. The distance calculations would be shown in the forthcoming slide. Assignment of each object to the respective center is shown in the rightmost column and the clustering so obtained is shown in figure 6.2. Here is the table 16.2 and figure 16.2. Their attributes given to A2 and then the third column is D1 which is the distance from cluster 1. This is the D2, that is for cluster C2. Then third is the distance d3 for cluster c3 which has been calculated, and the fourth and the last column is the cluster column. Yeah. To which cluster it belongs will we have to decide by using the minimum of these three distances d1, d2 and d3. And this initial cluster figure 16.2 shows the clusters with centroids marked in red. The calculation of the new centroids of the three clusters using the mean of the attribute value of a1 and a2 is shown in the table below. That the cluster with new centroids are shown. Now the value have been changed because of changing or shifting of the items from clusters, from one cluster to another. Now c1 has been calculated and c2 has been calculated for a1, a2, and old and new centers have been specified using black color and new center using red dot. We next reassign the 16 object to three clusters by determining which centroid is closest to each one, and this keeps on repeating until we find two iterations with the same or no change. Here figure 16.4 and 65 do not have no change of items from cluster 1 to c2 or c3. They all are same and cluster centroids have not been changed. Here the dimensions we have used are x is an object under clustering and number of objects under clustering. Ci is the ith cluster. Ci in small case the centroid of cluster Ci. Ni is the number of objects in the cluster Ci. C denotes the centroid of all clusters. K is the number of clusters. Now value of K is a matter of discussion over here because the K means service produce only one set of clusters for which user must specify the desired number of K clusters. In fact, K should be the best guess on the number of clusters present in the given data. We may not have an idea about the possible number of clusters for high dimensional data and for data that are not scatter plotted. Further, possible number of cluster is hidden or ambiguous in image, audio, video or multimedia format. There is no principled way to know what the value of K ought to be. We may try with successive value of K starting with 2. Then the process is stopped when the two consecutive K values produce more or less the same result or identical result. Normally K should be less than N, and there is a heuristic to follow. K versus cluster quality has been discussed over here. Usually there is some objective function to be met as a goal of clustering. One such objective function is sum square error, that is SSC. It is generated by summation of from I is equal to 1 to K, that is difference of square of sum of square of the difference of X minus Ci. This denotes the error if X is the cluster, Ci is the cluster centroid, Ci. Usually, this error is measured as distance norms like L1, L2 or L3 or cosine similarity. Here, K versus cluster quality has been discussed here with reference to an arbitrary experiment. Suppose the following results are obtained for the K. 1 to 8, if K is equal to N, then SSC would be 0. However, the cluster is useless. This is another example of overfitting. Choosing initial centroid. Another requirement in K-means algorithm is to choose initial cluster centroid for each K would be clusters. It is observed that the K-means algorithm terminate whatever be the initial choice of the cluster centroid. It is also observed that the initial choice influences the ultimate cluster quality. In other words, the result may be trapped into local optima if initial centroids are chosen properly. One technique that is usually followed to avoid the above problem is to choose initial centroids in multiple runs, each with a different set of randomly chosen initial centroids, and then select the best cluster which with respect to the some quality measurement criterion then. For example, SSE. How are this strategy suffers from combinational explosion problem due to the number of all possible solution. A detailed calculation have been studied over here for possible number of combination. If for C formula is for combination is C and comma K. For C and one comma the formula is given as can be expanded as 1 by factorial K, then summation is I is equal to 1 to K minus 1 raised to the power K minus I multiplied by 1 to K I raised to the power N. For example, if there are 0, 10 raised to the power 10 different ways to cluster 20 items in 4 class. Thus, the strategy having its own limitation is practical only if the sample is negatively small, minus 100 to minus 1000, and K is relatively small compared to N. Distance measurement is usually denoted by either Euclidean distance. L2 norm is the best measure when objects are defined in n-dimensional Euclidean space. Other measures, namely cosine similarity, is more appropriate when objects are document type. Further, there may be other type of proximity measures that appropriate in the context of application. For example, Manhattan distance, that is L1 norm, etc. The distance measurement formulas have been given for SSE. Data in Euclidean space, L2 norm, SSE, summation from I is equal to 1 to K, then sum of square of distance is given. And distance in Euclidean space, that is L1 norm, gives the sum of absolute error, that is SA, with formula summation of I is equal to 1 to K and summation of X belongs to CI. For mod of CI minus X, that is the difference of the distance. For document type objects, the K-means agreement defines TC, that is total cohesion, which is the objective function which is called total cohesion, denoted as CC, and defined as summation which begins from I is equal to 1 to K and then summation X belongs to CI cos X comma CI, where cos XI is equal XCI is equal to X multiplied by CI, then mod of X and mod of CI. Now for the criteria of objective function with different proximity measures, for SSE using L2 norms to minimize the SSE. SSE using L2 norm is used to minimize the SAE. TC using cosine similarity to maximize the TC. Types of objects under clustering can be applied only when the mean of the cluster is defined. Hence, it names K-means. Let the cluster mean of a cluster CI is defined as CI is equal to 1 divided by NI, then summation of X, X belongs to CI. In other words, the mean calculation assumed that each object is defined with numerical attributes. Thus, we cannot apply the K-means to objects which are defined with categorical attributes. In fact, the K-means is a very general clustering algorithm and can be used with a variety of data types such as documents, time series, etc. When we use SSE, it is an objective function, and the objective is to minimize then the cluster centroid is the mean value of the objects in the cluster. When the objective function is defined as SAE, that is L1 norm, minimizing the objective function implies the cluster centroids as the median of the cluster. Those two interpretations can be readily verified as given in the next slide. Case 1, to calculate SSE, we know the formula of SSE, as we discussed in the previous slide, to minimize SSE, we assume that SSE is equal to 0. When we apply it for 0, the minimum distance as an error, standard error is 0, is calculated as 0. Here, to calculate, and it derives to the formula CI is equal to 1 divided by Ni, then summation x belongs to CI x for Now, the time and space complexity. The best standard for minimizing SSE for a cluster is the mean of the objects in the cluster. It is given by the formula CI is equal to 1 divided by Ni, that is summation of x. For to calculate SAE or to minimize SSE to 0, we put it for the equivalent to 0 to the formula. Then the formula is CI is equal to the median of subset of x, where x belongs to CI. Thus, the best standard for minimizing SAE of a cluster in the median of the object in the cluster. Now, the complexity analysis of the k-means algorithm says that time to a complexity of the k-means algorithm can be expressed as Tn equal to big O n multiplied by m multiplied by k multiplied by l, where n is the number of objects, m is the number of attributes in the object definition, k is the number of clusters, l is the number of iteration. Thus, time requirement is a linear order of number of objects, and the algorithm runs in a modest time if k is less than n. Space complexity has been given by Sn is equal to O to big O notation and multiplied by m plus k, that is space requirement in the linear order if n is and if k is less than n. Advantages: k means is simple, is the first very advantage. It also, the second is, it is also efficient both from storage requirement and execution time of point of view by saving distance information from one iteration to the next. Then the limitations are, the k-means is not suitable for all types of data. For example, k-means does not work on categorical data because mean cannot be defined. K-means second limitation is to find a local optima and may actually minimize the global optima. K-means has trouble clustering data that contains outliers. Next limitation is it cannot handle non-global clusters, and k-means algorithm not really beyond the scalability issue and not so practical for large database. Thank you.